Hello, hello. I have arrived. Artist, archivist, VTuber, and tonight, theoretical medical professional and interdimensional tactician. You can call me Tiberius Vanderfield. Hello, hello. So before we get started, I just wanted to share some thoughts. So yesterday I was made aware of a choice that Ubisoft made with regards to their upcoming Assassin's Creed game, Assassin's Creed Shadows, I believe it is. But yes, anyway. So, in short, they created a figure to promote the game that features a one-legged Tory gate. If you're familiar with those, they are most often found at the entrances of shrines and whatnot. Yes, in a two-legged form, typically. But yes, so the particular issue with this one is that the one-legged Tory is sort of a symbol of the... Yeah, there was one at the near the site of the bombing of Nagasaki. So this depiction in a figure has been considered to be very disrespectful of a, you know, rather tragic event in Japanese history. But yes, so I wanted to share that information as it was shared with me. Yeah, I don't want to say this to, you know, incite anything against anyone. I don't want anyone, you know, I never want anyone to harass anyone over anything, basically. But I wanted to make this known because I feel like it would be somewhat irresponsible for me to go through this, like, continue going through this event, having just been made known of a, or made aware of a, you know, recent issue with them. Yeah, Ubisoft has done a lot that is worthy of criticism, but since this is so recent, and as far as I'm aware has happened, like, you know, during the time that we've been doing this, I don't know, I felt like it was important to share my thoughts on that before we got started. But yes, so, with that being said, we are going to continue the event. But yeah, that is not, no current plans to change anything about that. But yes, speaking of, last time around, we got to the final chapter, or the final gameplay mission of the event. And so, we are now deep into attempts of beating the final boss of the event. So, we're gonna see how that treats us. I've spent some time thinking about it, and I've spent some time thinking. I was going to say something else, but I suppose I can't think of another thing that I've spent time doing. Thinking and planning, perhaps? But anyway. So, where was I? Right, so, schedule. Arknights will continue until such time as we beat the event. That could very well be today, but it might not be. We shall see. But yes. So, I don't imagine it will take until Saturday like I had initially planned. But yes, one way or the other though, it will continue until such time as the event is done, one way or the other, whether we complete it or whether the event ends. And let's see, anything else to be said before we get started? Ah, so yes, right, time. So yes. Friday, the Friday stream should start somewhere around 9 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. The Saturday stream, should that happen. Again, the Friday stream is also a little bit up in the air. Once we have completed this this event, I'm going to take a short break because we've been playing Arknights a lot. I have been streaming a lot these past 2 weeks. More than 2 weeks. Or actually, I guess it has been a little over 2 weeks. All this is to say, I've been playing the game a lot recently, and I'm a little bit tired. Well, okay. I'm not tired of the game. The game is fun. I've enjoyed that. I'm tired of having streamed a whole lot. Like, normally I stream, you know, 3 times a week, and this is my 4th stream this week already. Yeah, usually I stream 3 times a week with, like, a day or so in between streams. Often I don't even stream 3 times a week. So, this has been a much bigger workload of streaming than I'm used to. And again, I'm kind of tired. But yes, part of that is for reasons outside of streaming. not being quite as careful with my sleep schedule as I probably ought to be. But it is what it is. We shall make it through this day, and I think that we will do well. We could very well complete this event. So, without further ado, let us get started. Ba-ba-ba-bum. Video games. So, this is where we find ourselves, in this lab. At the center of this lab is a being known as the Essence of Evolution, or at least there will be once the mission starts. This creature is troubling to us, to say the least. But one crucial thing about it is that it doesn't move. So, what it does instead is it spawns a lot of other enemies that we have to deal with. And so, up until now, I've been treating it somewhat similar to other bosses, thinking in terms of having to beat it. But, in theory, that shouldn't be necessary, because after a certain point, it will transition to a phase where it will start to deal damage to itself, which is good, because I don't do a whole lot of damage to it very quickly. Yes, especially not in that phase, when it takes, as I understand it, about 99% less damage from all damage sources. So, but yes, I did look it up a little bit on the wiki. I didn't look up any guides or anything in particular. I did still want to try and figure this out with my own understanding as best as I possibly could. So, the essence. But yes. So I've come up with a plan. I think it's going to do better. Whether or not it actually succeeds remains to be seen, but I do think it's going to do better. So, long story short, the new strategy involves a whole lot more, or rather, yeah, okay. The old strategy, again, I was treating the boss like something that I needed to defeat. With the new strategy, I'm treating it more like something that I need to survive, like it is an environmental feature that I simply must outlast. And to that end, I have put together a team that is much more heavily focused on defense. Yes, you can see I swapped in two additional defenders, Liskarm and Fire Whistle. But yes, beyond that, we also swapped in Shiryuki for some more AoE damage. Not a whole lot of other revisions that were made. But yeah, I didn't choose Shiryuki specifically because of any, like, special attribute that she specifically has. I mostly just chose her because she is also a fairly high-level artilleryman that we have. But yeah, the rest of our team should be, you know, more or less as we were using them before, just in different positions. Fire Whistle, again, wasn't chosen for any... Well, okay. I did choose her a little bit for some of the attributes she had. I kind of wanted to see if Wildfire would affect multiple targets when she uses it with her melee attacks, or if it just only hits the one enemy. But yes, Scorched Earth, we've seen, does hit multiple targets, even when used as a melee attack, because it produces the... It still produces the AoE on the ground. So that could be useful. I'm still not 100% sure about that, but it could be useful. And I have the initial strategy, and I've got a few backup strategies, adjustments to make that we can also try. But yeah, I wanted to see how Wildfire treats us, and I wanted a defender with 3 block, and so thus Fire Whistle. Yeah, Liskarm also was chosen, not really for any specific attribute that she has, though she could be useful for certain strategies that we might try later on. Yes, with her ability to generate skill points. But yes, so I spent not a whole lot of time, but I did spend some time producing a visual aid for us. And I put it on the other computer. So let me get it. Let's see. How's the easiest way to get this? Here we are. But yeah, I made it on my laptop rather than Hello, chefs. Good to see you. Yes. Ah, I just remembered also. Yeah, so from my feed. Yeah, Alpaca Bowl 420. Thank you for the follow. Forgot to mention that the other day. But yes, so I'm about to show a diagram that might not make any sense, and it might not be super well visible either, but so this is more or less the mission space with a few ideas that I've been working on. So as you can see, we plan to place Perfumer here, covering Blitz and Tachanka. Yes, it might not be super obvious what everyone is and what they are all doing from just the visuals, but please bear with me. But yeah, Estelle over here is covering this space. It's important that she is there specifically because then Catapult's range can extend that far to also hit some enemies there. Because yes, Estelle is going to be doing a lot of damage per attack, but her attacks are going to be fairly slow once the Originutant tumors arise. But yes, and on the right hand side we have Telopsis with Liskarm and Fire Whistle. It's not important that they be in any specific location here. But yeah, the actual position of them is more or less arbitrary. What's less arbitrary is the plan to put Shirayuki here facing left and Ash here facing right. But yeah, I wanted to make sure that we're both able to sort of hit enemies effectively, create a area here where we can do a lot of damage. But yeah, Ash is there. I don't know if we want Ash specifically, but I do think that she has some of the best DPS that we can get for this event. And I want her to also be able to deal with the giant mutant rock spiders once they spawn. But yes, Shirayuki is there because she is able to do AoE damage to take out the smaller enemies quickly. And so yes, so you may notice the area where the giant rock spiders spawn on the left is not covered. So my plan there was we have a number of high explosive Originium bombs, and I intend to use them probably on this tile, probably sequentially, to detonate one after the other to take out as many of the giant mutant rock spiders as possible. Because we, again, don't have any immediate way to damage them. We could possibly, if we wanted to, adjust Perfumer's position, face her upwards, and be able to place catapults, say, here facing right, or here facing left. That does still only cover two of them, and it also takes her away from being able to support Estelle, which we don't want. Yeah, Estelle's self-healing is very important here because that allows us to place her outside of, Perfumer's healing range, or anyone's healing range, really. But yeah, you'll notice this other yellow area that I drew in. That was another theory that I was considering, possibly slotting in Firewatch somewhere here. Firewatch being a different character from Fire Whistle. I don't know that we've used Firewatch before, but she does have some traits that would be quite useful for us. But yes, she is a sniper with very high attack and a long and wide range, and she can also drop bombs, which is quite nice. But yes, so I think that covers basically everything that we need to go over with my strategy. But yes, explaining it to myself is an important part of it, I think. Okay, so now that we have done that, the only question is whether or not I'll keep that in mind well enough to execute on it. But yes, so I did have another idea. We've got some more leeway for some changes to the strategy, but we'll get to those if and when they become necessary once again. But yes. So, we can skip this.
Where did I leave my ammunition belt?
So, Myrtle, right here, down, Doctor. Quickly. And we also have learned that we need to use Frost to cover this right-hand side.
Don't let them get the drop on
it's me. Not outside of the realm of possibility, I don't think, that we could get Ash out soon enough that frost isn't necessary there, but we wouldn't be able to put Ash into the position that we want her in right away. So it would still not be ideal.
Laying out the welcome mat.
Yes, nice. We want to chunk it down as quickly as possible so that we can start generating deployment points with Myrtle quickly. But yes, we're going to start seeing some damage come from the essence soon. But yes. We are going to need defense on the left-hand side. We might have actually already messed this up. Okay, yeah. Okay. So.
Should we fight again?
We've not succeeded at this yet. So I'm not really willing to take too many chances here. So
permission to
skip
attack
that.
Granted. Tactical support system online.
But yes. Mainly the reason that I considered not having Frost in our lineup here, or not placing her immediately, is so that I can have her not be in the lineup. So we could potentially put someone else down, or put someone else on the team. But yes. There's nothing especially wrong with Frost, but since she's not going to be contributing to the final strategy, there's a part of me that, or to the final formation, I should say, there's a part of me that does think maybe we should try to avoid her if possible. Yeah, again, it doesn't matter where we place Liskarm versus where we place, where we place Liskarm or the... Still a little bit frazzled. Yeah, it doesn't matter where we place Liskarm specifically versus where we place Firewatch. We just need both of them. And it seems that we have a little bit of an issue here. Okay. I think we're actually in a situation where we probably should make use of Frost's abilities a little bit more.
I won't let it discourage me.
Because yes, if we attack that enemy on the right, and this might actually be a situation where it'd be good to start using
do be careful, everyone.
Lands.
Tactical
but anyway.
Support system online.
So if we lay down more welcome mats, we can use those to take out enemies a little bit faster with a bit less of a DP investment. Of course, on the other hand, we might not need to place them too aggressively. Yes. Another thing that I understood from reading the wiki is that where exactly excrescences and whatnot spawn is at least somewhat random, which is a bit of an issue.
Artillerymen in position.
Alright, if we can take this one out, that does leave us with two excrescences getting past us.
Oh shoot! Hurry up, Doctor! We gotta move!
Could we get away with not deploying... I don't know that we can get away with not deploying Tachanka. Because if we don't deploy Tachanka, then we only have one blocker on this side, Myrtle. And Myrtle, of course, we already have the issue that she only, she can't generate DP while blocking. So it is possible that we might want to swap Myrtle out for another Vanguard who can do so. That, or we just need to get lucky. If these are indeed fully random. Okay, that enemy's done. And yeah, we are now in a situation. Okay, the excrescence is going that way, and we can't do anything about it, but we can actually do something about it. We just did. Okay, so.
Artillerymen in position.
If we do this, I don't think we've really solved any of our problems, but. We've made the situation different. And that was not a great play. Because now we need to take one out with a welcome mat, but we're not going to have the chance to. Well, we might have to fall back onto our classic plan of good enough. If we can do it well enough, then we can live with what we achieve. A perfect result is not always going to be achievable. So, we don't need Blitz just yet.
I have a visual.
Sooner rather than later. Well, I was going to say sooner rather than later, I want to be able to deploy our medic, but we don't need to worry about that too much. But yes, we do want to deploy Blitz before too long. That was probably not strictly necessary. Okay, so now we can deploy Shirayuki. And we'll want Estelle before too long, I do believe. And in turn, we'll want Catapult as well. Yes, Frost is probably not going to be a huge concern. Actually, we can retreat her to get our other units out a little bit faster. Okay.
Time for business.
Okay, we've lost. Okay. So we did need to deploy Blitz a little bit earlier.
Don't worry. I've done this a bunch of times.
So yes, we might need to refine our strategy to be less DP hungry. Yet again, that is something of a shortcoming of using higher level that was not the place where I meant to place Myrtle, but I suppose we'll have to live with it. Okay. I wonder. No, I don't think that would work well for us. But I do think that we could make that work. That would allow us to, use her skill sooner.
Welcome, that set.
I wonder.
Understood.
I've had a very sort of set order in which I've been doing this, but that might not actually be the best plan. I do want Chanka soon, though. Okay, this is doing pretty well for us, actually. Of course, one of the issues now is that Myrtle is in a position where she can't easily be healed. Granted, we don't necessarily need Myrtle to stay around for very long.
Very well. All ends.
But we are going to need more healing on the, or we're going to need some healing, any healing whatsoever, on the right-hand side before too long. Myrtle might just be about to perish. Will she survive this? No, she will not. Okay. We could have gotten a little bit more back if we retreated her sooner. And that was definitely a pretty big loss for us, to be honest. But as long as we can get Colossus out before we lose Shirayuki, I think we're probably okay. We're not in a great position. But we are in a position where we can make use of T'Chanka's ability there. I do feel like we maybe wanted Catapult. Okay, yeah, we have lost. Yes, we have. Okay. So yes.
Damn it!
Deploying Shirayuki early did benefit us quite a bit. We could also have deployed Ash early for a similar benefit, maybe not quite as strong of one, but it would have also been useful and it would have cost us less DP.
Let's look alive out there.
But yeah, again, this was a strategy that I came up with basically just sort of on a whim. I didn't actually test any of this beforehand, so... okay. Again, I was thinking Stay about alert. Playing Ash really early, but that very, very nearly went very poorly for us, so... Yeah, the rate at which the excrescences spawn doesn't seem to be that random. Granted, I don't remember if it was specifically the excrescences that it said spawned randomly. Oh dear. Okay, we should have laid the welcome mat in front of Myrtle, and we did have the opportunity to play Pachanka there, but I didn't notice it, and so we did lose out there a little bit. So, perfumer. Again, we want to keep Myrtle out to some extent. We're not too bothered by her potentially going down, but we do want her to be alive. We want her to be alive longer than she was last time, at least. Yes, between the two pistoleros of Team Rainbow on the right-hand side, we're actually not hurting too much for... Yeah, we're not hurting too much for enemy clear. But I do want... okay. We shouldn't get too ahead of ourselves, because we've again had a big issue with the left-hand side. So... We can get a lot of mileage out of what we've already got here.
That's fine with me. How do you like this, sir?
So, we're going to want Estelle sooner rather than later, I do believe. But, we're not doing desperately bad. Yes, and our units on the right-hand side are being healed pretty quickly.
This one's for you.
I don't know if there's any specific way that we want to position Blitz specifically. I don't think there's any one location that's more valuable for him. But one thing we definitely want to do, and we do want to wait until we've got a few more DP. Actually, we can recruit more units. Okay. Yes, Liskar. Here we are. So, we're doing quite well. Ah, rock spiders. Rock spiders, I forgot about those. More specifically, I forgot when they spawned. And I forgot where they spawned, actually.
Let's get
any excrescences we can stop from reaching the right-hand side is definitely to our benefit. Yes. Or the... Did I say right-hand side? I meant left-hand side. Okay. Now we can switch in Shirayuki without too much issue. And I think we're in a good position. We may not be in the ideal position. We're definitely not in an amazing position. Considering that the bomb is about to be destroyed, but... Okay, yeah, that is not safe to deploy there. Okay. Yeah, I was a little bit too excited about the bomb, and now we've used two of them without too much gain from it. Granted, it's not a huge deal. Yeah, it's not a huge deal, because we don't necessarily need the bombs. I'm mostly concerned with them as a way to... Yeah, I'm mostly concerned with them as a way to get rid of the giant rock spiders, but we don't... I don't know, they're not that desperately an issue, necessarily. Alright, someone just went down. Or did they? No, yeah, someone definitely went down. Oh, Catapult did. Okay. Okay. And yeah, now that Catapult's gone, we don't have the backup on the left-hand side. Alright. I think switching or using Perfumer's other skill may have been a mistake there. Because since she was healing very infrequently, we were losing out on, Catapult didn't get the healing she needed, I think. But, other than that, the strategy was working pretty well. Yes, Perfumer. Yeah, it's not quite a doubling. I was mostly using fine blending because I was thinking I would want to rely more on Perfumer's passive healing. But we're definitely in a situation where passive healing isn't that viable. And the main recipient of the passive healing, Estelle, doesn't need it that badly, because she is able to heal herself with her own passive. So the early sniper strategy did help us out a lot. Yeah, Ash and Shirayuki contributing early on helped us get rid of a lot of enemies early into the fight. But yes, the Originium bomb blunders did hurt us a lot. The spiders on the right-hand side did get handled pretty well, but we would need to handle them a little bit better. Yeah, Catapult could be leveled up to make her a little bit more effective. I don't know. Okay, she doesn't have a tremendous amount of attack, but it's not terrible. It's definitely a lot worse than some of our other units, but it's not that big of a deal. I am a little bit surprised that Catapult went down. And I wonder if having Perfumer on her other skill will prevent that.
Permission to attack granted.
Yeah, beyond that, the only issues that I saw were just kind of a few timing mistakes here and there.
Stay alert.
But yes, again, if we start placing snipers relatively early on the left-hand side, we can get a lot of value out of that. Alright, take them out, and then immediately use her skill.
Move. Setting up.
And we should be able to take this out very well. Okay, Chanka is on the field. So, the day is saved. You don't need to worry about it. I'm wondering a little bit if we should maybe deploy Calopsis on the left-hand side as our first medic. She won't have the passive healing of Calopsis or Perfumer, but she will have the... she'll have her own healing, but she'll also have the ability to increase our deployment point, indirectly increase our deployment point gain by way of improving Myrtle's skill uptime. And now we have medic access on both sides anyway, so it's not a huge deal. So yes, so we are doing quite well. Yes, with our units as they are, we are not having too many issues.
Artillerymen in position.
Okay, this is clean. Pretty clean so far.
I have a visual.
Yes, it honestly might be more valuable to deploy Estelle sooner, especially... Now we're seeing the tumors spawn, and we definitely don't want those alive, if at all possible. Yes, Frost can pretty readily be swapped out here, I think. Oh dear. Right, I didn't take into account the lack of Blitz. Okay, that's very bad. Because yeah, we are now precisely one missed enemy away from death. So that's definitely not a situation that I would like to be in. And yeah, I was expecting the giant rock spiders would spawn all at once, but it seems that is not the case. So... okay, they definitely have it within them to destroy the explosives before we really have a chance to make use of them.
Panicking just spreads the fire faster.
Yeah, we more or less want as much uptime on as many of our skills as possible. There's basically never any situation when we don't want as many skills active as we can.
Initiation. Activating arch unit.
Yeah, stuff like this is part of why I was thinking about using Philopsis.
Whatever you say, watch how I get them with one shot. Let me tell
I was just about to say, or I did say that we wanted as much uptime as we can get, but that was a situation when we didn't necessarily need it that desperately. Yes, we're about to see a tumor reach Estelle. If we can avoid that at all, we definitely want it avoided.
Do you think I have a surprise?
Part of me almost wonders if we should maybe... Okay, just Catapult just went down. So Catapult definitely does not have the survivability we're looking for this, it seems like. Okay, we do... Boot just went down. Ah, Ash did. So...
A fatal error occurred during the operation. Reboot the system to proceed.
We are losing units at this point. I was hoping that would not be the case. So, now we need to switch onto a different strategy, I think. Well, Because here's the thing. We can only heal so fast. But yeah, especially if we need to be able to heal all of our units, immediately. Curious. Okay. Let's do some more thinking. Once again, I had thought of some other things, but we will see. So the units we're losing are ranged units. So that means that we can't rely on... the units we're losing are ranged units, so we can't rely on, you know, not being within melee range being a significant factor there. There are ways that we can get damage with a unit that can also heal. Because, yeah, Ash is very valuable. But it's also valuable to keep our units alive. Perhaps that goes without saying, but... In theory... Let me actually confirm this so I'm not just saying whatever. In theory, I think that we should be able to get healing range on Catapult. And Catapult isn't necessarily the number one unit we want to be alive, but we could at least get healing range on Catapult if we were to deploy Honeyberry here, I think. Because, yeah, her range extends 3 squares in front, and then, yeah, 2 squares to the side. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay. So, yes, Honeyberry and any other wide range medic, I suppose, but, Honeyberry is the one that I think of. She is my go-to. Just because she's the one that we've used before. But yes, Honeyberry could heal Catapult there. Having another medic instead of another sniper is a little bit of a... is a little bit worrisome. But we weren't really running into the issue of an excess of enemies on the right-hand side. So we might not need to worry that much about it. But yes. The other choice is Hibiscus the Purifier, whom we've used before. Because she is able to deal damage and heal at the same time. But yeah, one way or the other, though, we definitely need to keep our units being healed as much as possible. Because once we get into that final phase, we definitely need the healing. Because, yeah, Catapult going down is a very quick way for our defenses on the left-hand side to be compromised very quickly. One thing we could do... I'm not sure that this would be a good idea. In fact, I'm pretty sure it would be a bad idea, but... Well, okay. What would be a good way to go about it? I suppose we could switch out Blitz for, say, we could swap out Blitz for Gummy or Spot or anything like that, to provide a little bit more healing to, Catapult as well. But again, if we're, because yeah, Ash also went down, and yeah, we wouldn't be able to position Gummy in such a way that she can heal Ash and Catapult. So again, if Ash is going to be going down at a certain point, she's could possibly be swapped out for another unit who can provide more value. Yes. Because yeah, again, with the number of enemies that we're facing, we definitely need some way to take out enemies before they pile up too much for Estelle. If they are not dealt with, then they simply will destroy us. So yes. So, if I was a little bit more mindful of when I activated her Sacrificial Strike, that could have been useful. But that wasn't, like, the only issue, I don't think. Changing Ash out for Honeyberry would pretty radically alter our strategy, and in a way that I had not accounted for earlier. But my backup strategies also didn't account for the fact that the snipers were going to be the ones that were going down. But yeah, it's not... I understand that the boss does true damage, so it's not as though units with higher defense are going to go down any slower or anything like that, but with more HP, they might be able to survive. Would they be able to survive more effectively, though, actually? I guess, yeah, I was thinking of placing Honeyberry specifically there, but that's, in theory, it shouldn't be necessary. What would be another good place to put her if I was going to put her somewhere? But yeah, if we were to place her here, go 1, 2, 3, and cover all of these units. Not cover our other medic, but that's not the worst thing in the world. But yes. Then, on the right-hand side, we could keep using just Shirayuki up top. I'm very not confident in not having Shirayuki. Of course, Honeyberry being a medic, she doesn't need to be within another medic's range, so we don't need to worry about that. But yes, if we were to place her... I don't know if there's anywhere we can easily place her that she can support units up here, while also supporting units over here, even with her pretty remarkable range. I'm trying to think. If she were to be facing downwards, then she'd cover a space of 1, 2, 3 there, but yeah, there's no one there. She'd cover both of our defenders here, but that's not necessarily the issue. But yeah, I'm not seeing a situation in which Frost is not going to be incredibly valuable to us. Because yeah, she is a very important way to get enemies cleared early on in the mission. Yeah, because again, the problem is math. The problem is our... The problem is our units are going to be taking damage at a fairly constant rate. So, the essence of evolution, once it's in its final phase, is going to be dealing about 800 damage every, apparently 7.7 or 7.17 seconds. So, the DPS on that is not huge, but it's definitely considerable. 7.17. So yeah, so that is about, let's round that up to 112 DPS. But yes, Telopsis heals not that fast. Yes, Telopsis heals once every if it'll, there we go, 2.85 seconds, and she has 283 attack. Yes, 2.85. Yes, so with Telopsis, we do lose the DPS race. We could very easily just train her some more, and perhaps should. You know, this is my first time realizing that Enkephalin increases her range. How much does it increase her range? It increases, it gives her another frontal tile, which is not super valuable for what we're doing, but it's a thing. Whoops. But yes, with Perfumer, we do also have Perfumer's passive healing, which helps us with the DPS race. Yes. So, Perfumer, I think, is able to win it on her own. So again, that's assuming that she's only healing exactly three targets. Yeah, if she is not healing exactly three targets, then we are losing. But yes, Perfumer heals. Her healing per second is 0.85. Just slightly too low to win the DPS race, actually. Granted, she does also have, yeah, 300 times, yes, 0.035, an additional 10.5 DPS. So with that, she is able to win. With that, she is able to win, but Telopsis is just slightly too low. So we do need to level up Telopsis just a little bit. Granted, again, if we do have Enkephalin up, and we can have Enkephalin up quite a bit more than usual if we place her by Liskarm. Yeah, if we have Enkephalin up, then she is... She's definitely winning the DPS race. She can win the DPS race with a lot more... with a lot higher DPS in that circumstance. But yes. I suppose it's never... Like, we can't really go overboard necessarily until we promote her. Like, that would be the only thing that we could do to, like, make things worse for us. But I don't know. I feel kind of nice having them matched.
Reading package data. Installation complete.
So yes. So with this, I do think it's important that we keep Telopsis within Liskarm range. Because we're relying on Enkephalin, because Telopsis is going to need to heal more than three targets. If we swap out Honeyberry, it might not be as big of a deal, because that will take some pressure off of her. Okay. Actually, hold on. Oh, wait, I just realized. Right, okay. Yeah, with the way we're set up, we're also in a losing position with Perfumer, because Perfumer needs to heal more than three units. That's troubling. So yeah, I think with that, we do definitely need to swap out Ash. We need another medic. So, it's either swap out Ash... Oh dear. But yes, we either need to swap out Ash or we need to swap out Blitz. Because yeah, Frost, we currently can't justify swapping out Frost. We could swift off her for someone cheaper, but we do need someone who has roughly the same, a similar DPS to Frost and a similar cost to Frost. Because we need to get enemies dealt with on the right-hand side sooner. Yeah, she is an important part of our defense on the right-hand side. Yeah, our other units don't, could we... Okay. Liskarm is very important. Liskarm is very important. Fire Whistle, as much as I appreciate her as a person, is not as valuable. So, we could swap out Fire Whistle for another unit. We'd lose out on DPS, but if we keep Ash, if we can More specifically, if we swap Fire Whistle out for a healing defender, we can keep Ash around, and we can keep... Though she is going to have a much lower attack speed due to the tumors. Anyway, so it could be a bit less of an issue because of Shirayuki, but I'm not super confident about that. Anyway, if we swap her out for a healing defender, at the very least, that is less less damage that is potentially coming her way. Or rather, that's less healing pressure on our medics there. Which won't necessarily in itself win us the damage race, but it will help the situation a little bit. Spot might actually be the better choice here. I think we'll go with Spot, actually.
I won't ask about the meaning of this mission, then.
Please don't ask about the meaning of this mission. It's a troubling mission. You all don't want to think about it. But yes. Litz, likewise, could probably be swapped out for a healing defender. We haven't made use... I mean, we've used it, but we haven't, like... Our strategy doesn't exactly hinge on Litz's ability to, you know, stun enemies. And I almost wonder... So, Blitz costs 19, but a healing defender, like, say, Gummy, costs 16. So that is a lot cheaper. Of course... If we did want to be a lean into luck, we could also go with Croissant because of Miracle Field. But I don't want to do that, to be honest. And that's about all I have to say on the matter. But yes. Yummy is probably, again, if we're not making much use out of Blitz's shield, though we could make more use. Well, okay, again, the issue is healing. We need to take healing pressure off our medics so that we have a chance to be able to keep up with the damage once the essence gets into its final phase.
Ready to go.
So, with that in mind, since we're not using Blitz for that specific purpose, we don't need Blitz. We do want Liskarm, because Liskarm is going to contribute greatly to uptime of Enkephalin, or potentially uptime of Fine Blending, or whatever other skill we might have on Perfumer, if we choose to go that route. Frost, again, is more or less non-negotiable, as is Myrtle, and I'm very glad that neither of them are any more promoted than they are. But yes, Myrtle, I don't think there's anything we could really do about Myrtle. I think she's basically fine. She is in... I don't think we can upgrade her in such a way that it would benefit us. Yeah, any more cost any earlier into the mission would be devastating to us. Catapult's fine. Again, if she takes too much damage too quickly, she dies, but that's true of everyone. And I don't think we can increase her stats enough that it matters, especially because we can't... or like her defense and whatnot don't matter for this purpose, just as long as she is present. Yes, the Chonka is another unit that's maybe not all that necessary, at least not to Chonka specifically. Another unit I was considering using was Lo Xiaohe. So yeah, Lo Xiaohe would also be able to attack at range without having to deal with the, without having to deal with the issues inherent in the other, or the, what's the word I'm looking for? Without having to deal with the issues inherent in the, with the tumors. There we go. We're not going to be facing a whole lot of tumors on that area, or at least not as many as we're facing with Estelle, but still. Yeah, again, with Estelle, we are in a situation where we do pretty desperately need to keep her well, basically. If there was some other way to heal, like, one additional unit at a time, or if there was a way to clear units a little bit more efficiently, that would be so valuable to us. Because, yeah. I don't think Catapult... Yeah. even if we were to swap catapult out for, say, meteorite, I don't think we'd have the DPS that we could rely on just Gummy. I do think we still need someone behind Gummy to provide a little bit more damage at range. And there's not any great way we can get around that, I don't think. The best thought in my mind is maybe the Terra Research Commission. Though, actually, no. Yeah, okay. So there's not that much that they can do other than be another source of DPS a little bit. But they're also going to take up healing. So, I mean, if we want them to be alive, basically, but which ideally we do, but so what else can we do? Ash, there's nothing we can do to make Ash heal, and I don't think there's anything we can do to make any other sniper heal, and I don't think that swapping Ash out for a non-sniper is going to help us, because we do, well, again, without, except if, yeah, with healing, if we swap her out for a healer, that would help some of our issues. But again, it's hard to understate the value of the DPS that she provides. Okay, let's start testing our new-ish strategy.
Stay with me.
A snowstorm will bury this battlefield.
Nope. Okay.
Good scenery here, Doctor.
All right. So, Frost and Myrtle. Very, very important that we use Frost and Myrtle.
We're ready for company.
Could have made that a little bit quicker by deploying a welcome mat, but it is what it is.
Ooh, almost dozed off.
Gather around, guys.
Setting up.
That might. No, that's gonna work. That's fine. Okay. So. Sure, Yuki, I think we want sooner rather than later. Though we might want to wait until after the thing explodes, but we also might not. I'm not sure. We do want Tachanka soon. Tachanka fast is good. So, we need healing soon, also. Well. Okay. I suppose since we have Ash on the team, we should use her. Alright, the thing is going to do its thing soon, so we should definitely get Philopsis out soon also. Yeah, so it's not until the rock spiders start spawning that things really start to get frightening for us.
Exterminate.
Please do exterminate. These things need to be obliterated. Dummy?
I have to get serious now.
Yes, we want defenders on the right-hand side sooner rather than later.
I have a visual.
Honestly, well, no. I was going to say taking out enemies a little bit slower around, I've misjudged the situation. Okay. I don't think there's anything we can do about that tumor, especially, yeah. Okay. That was kind of a waste. We should have deployed catapult sooner, I think. I'm kind of forgetting what order we did all that in. But Ash was not the play there, I don't think. We needed to wait on Ash. Sip. Well, I haven't sipped yet, but. Now we sip.
Waiting for further instructions.
I'm here to help!
Yeah, it does seem that it's.
Stay alert.
It does seem to spawn excrescences at a predictable. In a predictable pattern. So it might not actually be random, or it might.
We're counting on you again today,
It might just be the tumors that are random or something like that.
Setting up.
Yes, we should be able to handle all this.
Roger.
So, early Shirayuki might be good as well. It might not be. Who knows? But we do need to Chanka soon. Okay, we waited too long at the Chanka. Is that enemy is technically not on a Okay, well, we've still let an enemy leak, we've let two enemies leak. Okay, that's bad.
Oh shoot! Hurry up, Doctor! We gotta move!
This is very, very challenging. We could get some somewhat better results by leveling up some of our units a bit more. But again, the real issue is just, like, it's not DPS, it's survival.
Stay alert.
Yeah, at a certain point, our units just don't have the, don't have it within them to stand up to what they're being forced to endure. Wasn't as aggressive with the welcome mat as I maybe should have been, but it's also possible that being too aggressive with welcome mats cost me DP that I might have wanted to use for other things. But yes, the Chanka. I think we waited too long on the Chanka last time, which is a big part of our issue there.
Welcome mat set.
Okay. There we go. That's pretty clean.
All right then.
We want medics soon.
Serious now.
Deployed. Ready. Sever.
Ryuki, please kill.
I won't be afraid.
Yeah, Shiryuki is above half health, so we're not too worried about her. Okay, yeah, we're not facing the rock spiders anytime soon, or at least we're not facing them immediately.
Archunit charging.
Welcome, set.
We do want. Okay. We don't want too badly though. So we might actually be able to get away with catapult sooner than I had initially planned.
Intimidate the enemy? I'm capable of that.
Not doing too bad, though we are losing a little bit on the left side. Especially if that rock spider gets past us. Ugh. Okay, well, I think we just lost, yeah. Oh no. Yes, okay. I could have retreated Frost earlier and gotten more defenders. Oh well.
Relax. You're doing fine.
Thanks, Spot. I needed that. Very challenging. Are you winning? Yeah, not yet. But yet is the operative word.
Got it.
So, part of the issue could very well just be cost. Some costs are somewhat non-negotiable, but we could probably get some value out of some units that are less expensive than the ones we're deploying. Shouldn't let that thing, we don't need to trap that thing, basically, is what I mean to say. Immediately use her skill, and now we quickly deploy Shirayuki.
Understood.
But yes, we want to Chanka soon, We don't necessarily need Tachanka immediately, but we do, well, no, we do want Tachanka immediately. I don't think that we can get around that.
Setting up.
So, if we let another explosion go off, we lose Myrtle, so we don't want to let another explosion go off. Oh dear. Okay, we have lost a deploy, or, a, yeah. We've had trouble, basically, in short.
Yeah, yeah, fine.
So, we can get Perfumer on the field quickly.
So this is
Chiroyuki's skill has a pretty good uptime on it, honestly. I might have been sleeping on it a bit.
I have a visual.
So yes, with our defenses like they are, we might be able to get away with retreating Frost. Again, a little bit quicker than I was expecting to.
Let's get time to get serious.
Maybe use that skill at a somewhat inopportune time, but
we're counting on you again today, little apple. My pushover,
we can deploy you like so, and we want Catapult on the field as soon as we can get her. Because yeah, now the tumors are spawning, and that's going to be a big issue for us.
Thunderstorm.
Ah, hold on. Oh dear.
Very well. Seven.
Chiroyuki is not okay. Yeah, we needed another defender sooner.
Emergency squad, retreat with the injured operators. Everyone who can still fight, follow me and hold back the enemy.
So now we are running into the issue of enemies dying faster than, or enemies killing us faster than we can do anything about. I was hoping we wouldn't need to use Ash. And we might still be able to figure out a way to get around using Ash. Because again, I don't know if you were there for that, but with Ash, we were considering... Yeah, okay. Basically, we were considering swapping Ash out for Honeyberry, or at least some other medic to relieve some of the healing pressure on some of our medics. But that might not be the play. And in fact, it might be the play to swap Liskarn out for a healing defender. Alright. I am going to head to the bathroom real quick. I will be right back. Alright, I have returned. So, as a recap of the tactical situation, we revised our tactics pretty well, and we were able to start getting into the final phase of the essence pretty consistently. But the issue now that we're running into is the fact that it's sort of a two-pronged issue. One, we sort of start to lose our ability to out-heal the damage it does. And in doing so, oh, I just realized, as I was thinking of this just purely as a problem of living through the essence of evolution's damage with its attacks. But we're also taking damage from the enemies, aren't we? Anyway, basically what I was getting at is, since we're having to heal more than three targets with our medics who can heal three targets at once, eventually we get to a point where our medics are not sufficient to heal all of that, and then units start dying. And once units start dying, then we start... Yeah, then the issue becomes we lose, we lose, well, yes. But more specifically, we lose out on DPS and enemy clear, and then we just lose. So we need to think about things a little bit more. So we've already swapped out a few defenders for healing defenders. Liskarn, or not Liskarn, Blitz for Gummy, I guess we didn't have another defender, but we swapped Spot out. So, it It's hard to say what more we could reasonably do. If we really needed to, again, we considered swapping out Ash for Honeyberry. Because, yeah, I don't think there's a lot more else that we can do in terms of healing and damage dealing. Because, yeah, we've definitely, straight up, we have given up on trying to defeat the Essence of Evolution, because I don't think that I can reasonably, like, substantially shorten the ordeal by defeating it. But yeah, it's extremely important that we have these DPS sources, because we need to be able to take out enemies quickly, that we have these DPS sources because we need to be able to take out enemies quickly. In theory, Estelle might also need to be swapped out for a defender of some description at some point. Hard to say, but yeah. I guess she'd be swapped out for a healing defender specifically, though again, that does still leaves her in a somewhat awkward position. Yeah, I'm just not confident that Catapult is able to sort of support her like that. We could also... What could we also do? It's hard to say. Very challenging. Well, I suppose we can do no more than gather data. Yeah, again, I was trying to not use Ash because I was thinking we could probably get away without using Ash there.
Good scenery here, Doctor.
And I'm still not unconvinced that we can be without Ash, but
don't let them get the drop on.
Early Ash might be more valuable than early Shirayuki, if we're going to be using Ash at all.
We're counting on you again today, little apple.
Move! Deployed.
Yes, and... Oh, okay, never mind, we're fine. I was worried there. Our timing's a little bit weird there, but anyway, we've managed to get through the first big hurdle.
Laying out the welcome mat.
But yeah, we're almost certainly going to have to do something with Perfumer.
Alright then.
Setting up.
Okay.
Target spotted.
Archunit charging.
Yeah, we are out of phase in the battle where we can more or less rely on Perfumer's passive healing for a lot of what's troubling us.
On standby.
But we can't rely on her completely. Okay, things are about to get messy.
Intimidate the enemy? I'm here's something yucky for you.
If we retreat both of our retreatable units, immediately we can get Catapult quickly and not have to worry too much about all that. Very clean, very clean. Of course, now we're a little bit lacking in DPS on the right side.
Understood.
So yeah, we are probably going to need Shirayuki. This is all very worrying. We could maybe make a bomb work somewhat.
What's up? You're on the fly!
I'm kind of waiting to see if we can get the bomb to damage at least one giant rock spider.
Program initiating healing process. Red fragrance revive your mind.
Here's something yummy for you.
Yeah, the right hand side is holding together pretty well.
Very well. All ends on the game.
Yeah, we're not doing too bad, all told. Oh, right, it was out of range of the, essence. Yeah, Estelle's self-healing is really, really doing great for us. Okay, we did lose Catapult there. I guess it wasn't doing that great for us, but... Okay. Okay, who else did we lose? Shiryuki. Oh, I didn't realize that it wasn't in its final phase already. Okay.
Should we fight again, we will return the favor 100-fold.
So even with the healing that we have, even with the additional healing, that's not enough. Interesting. So, if we introduce another medic somewhere, that could help us some more. Because, let's see. So, a normal medic, a medical medic, can heal. How often do they attack? Every 2.85 seconds. So they do have the exact same interval between their heals as a multi-target medic. The difference being, of course, they have higher attack, generally speaking. But do they... No, I don't think we can justify switching to single-target medics. Like, in general or in any specific case, because we're going to be able to heal more per heal, but we're not going to be able to heal more, we aren't going to be able to heal more per, okay. Since everyone's getting attacked, everyone needs to be healed. Since everyone needs to be healed, we can't, like, be healing one unit and then healing another unit, because that's, even though each unit is going to be healed more, they're not going to be healed enough, I don't think. With the possible exception on the right-hand side, due to the fact that a lot of the units that we have there are pretty tough. Though, again, the issue is how much benefit are we going to get out of switching over to single target medics? It's worth considering, I think. If I had to pick one to swap out, I think it would be Alopsis. But I don't think we're going to continue this tonight. We're going to leave it for later. Because, yeah, let's... Comparing Onsul to Talopsis. Onsul does have more attack. He does also have the additional healing talent, which is a major reason why I consider him specifically. So he can kind of serve as a kind of bootleg multi-target medic. Honeyberry, likewise, can heal multiple units at once, sometimes. Energy. I do actually, hold on. Do therapists? She's a therapist, I believe. Yes. Or no, she's a wandering medic. Yeah. What therapist is a different one? Yes, wandering medic. What is the attack interval on a wandering medic? It is 2.85 seconds, the same. Okay. So we do have some other options. Because, yeah, again, part of the issue is just that the units that are going down aren't being healed fast enough. Whereas the ones who aren't going down are able to survive a bit longer between heals, in theory. Dual healing could be useful also. That's more consistent than additional target, additional healing. This is very interesting. Very interesting indeed. Okay, yeah, they are also cheaper than Telopsis, but not that much cheaper is part of the problem. We could also use Lancet 2, maybe. Lancet 2 having the benefit of not taking up deployment limit. But I don't think we... Like, part of the issue is that we have too many units out, so deploying more units is going to be kind of a problem. She doesn't heal very much either. So if we have her within healing range of anybody, then she's going to be taking up healing that could otherwise go to a unit who is somewhat more valuable. Telopsis also helps with skill cycling. I know that Telopsis is very good, and I'm very reluctant to swap her out. The reason I'm thinking about Perfumer is because she is able to ease the burden on everyone who provides healing, because she provides healing, like, passive healing globally. Yeah. Because again, the issue is, once we get to that final phase, we're just in a situation where we just need things to... We just need constant healing on everything. Because, yeah, so, like, having... I don't know. Having, like, more, skill uses, like, having roughly... I think it would be... Well, I don't know. She gives 0.15 skill points per second, when you normally get 1 per second. So that's... I don't think that's strictly an 85% like reduction in charge time. I'm not in the mind to do the math right now. What could we do? Yeah, I don't think we have enough damage to kill it. Like, I just don't think that that's going... I don't think that's realistic. At the very least, I don't know that we have enough time to figure out how to kill it. It's all very troubling. Yeah, again, I'm not eager to switch out Telopsis. And we might be able to get good use out of Telopsis if we were to level her up more. But I don't think even with that, we'd have the DPS, or the healing, the HPS, if you will, necessary to really make this happen. Because, yeah, we can't simply hold out against the things. We could maybe use the bombs to clear them out to make things a little bit easier on ourselves. Because, yeah, I was kind of hoping that we could maybe, again, get to that final phase and not be in a situation where we needed so much... Yeah, not be in a situation where we needed so much damage. Very troubling. Yeah, I don't think that we can really do a whole lot here, other than, again, just double down on healing. Because yes, we could, as another resort, we could swap out Liskarm for Nirl. I don't know that we have any other healing defenders on hand. Yeah, well, one way or another, it's too late to do any more attempts here, I think, so we're going to have to call it for the night. But yes, a challenging situation this has been, but we have made our attempts, and we have learned much, and what we have learned is that this thing is a big problem for us. So yeah, once again... the issue is the essence of evolution deals effectively 112 damage or so per second to all of our units over time. With our multi-target medics, we're just barely able to out-heal that, but we can only out-heal that if we have exactly three targets that we're healing. And with exactly three targets, we don't have the DPS necessary to take out enemies before they become an issue for us. So yeah, more healing from our other units would be valuable, but I'm not quite sure how I'm going to work that out at this point. Being able to use medic skills more often would be valuable, but I don't know that we can boost Telopsis and or Perfumer that much. Could be good with additional healing, or with her two target heals and her higher attack, if we keep her next to keep her next to Liskarm, so that Liskarm can continually give her skill points. If we put Spot a little bit forward, then we're also going to be able to have his heal target Shiryuki and so on, thus lessening the burden on Myr. I don't see much we can do with Catapult. We just need her to be in a situation where she can be healed faster. So, it actually might be... Liskarm on the left healing... Liskarm on the left healing, or providing skill points. Well, Then she'd have three targets that she'd be distributing skill points to, and I did confirm it's only one target and it's determined randomly. Her distributing skill points to one of three targets wouldn't help us that much because it would increase uptime, but it wouldn't increase it that much, I don't think. At least not as much as we would like. Granted, catapult skill is not useful to us, so if we can, like, not use it, we could maybe not have her get skill points. I don't actually know if Liskarm avoids giving skill points to someone who's already full on skill points. Yeah, again, a lot of this hinges on Catapult, and Catapult is just not able to do the damage that we need, or she is able to do the damage that we need. She's not able to survive the damage that we need her to survive. Again, the only other choice I can really think of would be to maybe try out, Hibiscus the Purifier, because she is able to deal damage and heal, so she might be able to assist somewhat. It's still a risky maneuver, but it's theoretically possible. Yeah. Chain medics. There are also chain medics. I've not tried that. I don't know how many chain medics that I have. I don't know how valuable they'd be, but it's definitely a possibility. Something to consider. Actually, I don't know how many chain medics there are in the game. There's at least one. I'm looking at one right now, but... Doesn't have dramatically increased attack over... Okay, just Paprika? Okay, that's what I was thinking. I was just looking at Paprika, and I couldn't remember seeing any others. But yeah, Paprika doesn't have dramatically more attack than, say, Telopsis or Perfumer. Don't know that her skills would be that good. Well, okay. Once again, it is time for us to wrap things up. If anyone has any raid suggestions, I would be delighted to hear them. If not, I can find a target on my own. I will take a sip. Very challenging. Well, we've learned a lot, like I said. We figured some things out. We're not in a situation where we can say comfortably... Yeah, We're not in a comfortable situation. So unless it turns out I'm dramatically misunderstanding something, like maybe if multi-target medics, like, have some sort of quirk with them that, like, makes them less applicable for this than I would have thought. Yeah, it's hard to say. I did just have a thought, but I don't know that we have enough time to execute on that. Well, anyway, okay. Let's not think too much. Let's wrap things up. So, tonight, since I'm not seeing any suggestions, I think we're going to go and visit Altariana, who is gearing up for their birthday celebration this Sunday. Yeah, playing some Baldur's Gate 3, it looks like. Yes. Pardon, I'm a little bit frazzled from all of our struggles so far. So, the raid. Altariana. Right, I need to go over the business first. So, tonight has been Arknights. Tomorrow will be Arknights. The day after will be Arknights, maybe. I would like to see if I can maybe get this beaten tomorrow, but that does seem a little bit unlikely with the relatively minimal progress we've made so far. Not impossible, but yeah, Sunday, believe it or not, Arknights. Sunday we will not be playing Arknights because the event will be over. Yes, and once the event is over, one way or the other, I am going to be taking a break. But yeah, I don't stream on Sundays anyway because it's the only day that I get off, basically. So I want to be able to have a day that I just can rest. Plus, I have a D&D game on Sunday. So, anyway. Raid. But yes, the customary raid message is, as always, we have arrived. And so, thank you all for being here tonight. I hope you've had a fine night. I hope that you'll continue to have a fine night every night. And I hope that you'll be well until the next time I see you. Thank you all very much, and farewell. Let us get this raid underway.